Before we go further, though, I think we need to do a quick review of the engineer's 10 scale and the decimal system. So the slide on the screen shows the engineer's 10 scale. This is often used to make measurements on drawings where the units on the scale need to be in decimal inches. So you can see we have 1.50, 2.750, and 3.125. All of these increments are in decimal inches when we're reading the 10 scale. In order to make more precise measurements, an inch can be broken down into tenths of an inch, hundredths of an inch, and thousandths of an inch. The dimension below is noted to three places of precision. When we refer to precision, we're talking about the number of places that the dimension is taken to the right of the decimal point. So the first number we see in this dimension, the 3, represents 3 whole inches. That's followed by the decimal point. And the first place after the decimal point represents the tenths place. The second place represents hundredths of an inch. And the third place represents thousandths of an inch. The dimensions on the 10 scale below represent one place precision, two place precision, and three place precision. So when I refer to that, I'm talking about the number of places to the right of the decimal point. One place, two places, three places. If I were reading these dimensions, because the first one goes to one decimal place, which is the tenths, I would say that this distance here is 1 5/10 inches. I might also refer to it as 1.5. The second dimension, because it's taken to hundredths, I would refer to as 2 75/100 inches, or I might say 2.75 inches. And the third dimension, because it's taken to three decimal places, which are thousandths of an inch, I would refer to this distance from this side to this side here as 3 125/1000 inches, or 3.125. What I've done here is I've taken 2 inches and I've divided each inch into 10 equal parts. So this each mark on there represents 1/10 inch increments. So the distance from the 1 to the first mark here is 1/10 of an inch. We would write that on a drawing as 0.1 if we were going to one place precision. The distance from the 0 to this mark here, which is 5/10 of an inch, would be written as 0.5 if we're using one place precision. The scale below shows 2 inches broken into 1/100 inch increments. So I took each tenth and I divided it into 10 equal parts, and each of those parts represents 1/100 of an inch. So if we started here and we counted each of those small marks all the way to the 1, there would be 100 of those marks. So now the distance from this mark to this mark, which before we said is 1/10 of an inch, if we put that to two place precision, we would say that that's 10 1/100 of an inch, which is written as 0.10. Likewise, over here, we're going to count to the 5/10 mark, which we did on the previous slide, but then we're going to count 2 more of those hundredths, and our total distance then is 0.52, 52 1/100 of an inch, which is written as 0.52. These dimensions represent two place precision. Now, let's take 1/10 of an inch and divide it into hundredths and then thousandths of an inch. All right, so follow the pointer here. I took 1/10 of an inch and I magnified it. So the distance from here, from this line to this line over here, is 1/10 of an inch. I divided that into 10 equal parts, and each of those parts represent 1/100 of an inch. So this is 1/100 of an inch here. Then I went between each of those marks and divided that into 10 equal parts, and each of those then represents 1/1000 of an inch. So here we have 1/100 of an inch, tenths, hundredths, 1/100. Down here we have 1/1000 of an inch. Here's our decimal place, tenths, hundredths, thousandths. 1/1000 of an inch would be that distance there. Now, of course, this is magnified. 1/1000 of an inch is much smaller than that. So we see 1/1000 of an inch. 1/1000 of an inch is written as 0.001. The fundamental unit of measurement for many machinists in the United States is 1/1000th of an inch, because we use the U.S. customary or the imperial system. For this reason, machinists often refer to 1/1000th of an inch as 1 thou. So if we follow that line of reasoning, rather than say 1/100th of an inch, a machinist may add a zero in the thousandth place and refer to this dimension here as 10 thou. So you see, if we go tenths, hundredths, thousandths, this is 10 thousandths of an inch. Instead of saying 1/100th, we say 10 thou. The dimension above, right here, is an example of three-place precision. Now, what if we took 1/1000th of an inch and somehow divided that into 10 equal parts between those two lines right there? Each of those increments would represent 1/10000th of an inch. We would write 1/10000th as 0.0001. So we have tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 10 thousandths. Machinists refer to 1/10000th of an inch as 1/10, which should not be confused with 1/10 of an inch. This is 1/10000th of an inch. 0.0001 is an example of four-place precision. So 0.1 equals 1/10 of an inch, 0.10 equals 10/100 of an inch, 0.100 equals 100/1000 of an inch, 0.01 equals 1/100 of an inch, 0.001 equals 1/1000 of an inch, or, as machinists say, 1 thou. 0.010 in machinist speak would be 10 thou. 0.325 we would read as 325 thousandths, or 325 thou. 0.955 inches is the diameter of a quarter, so we might say that as 0.955 thou. A quarter is 45 thousandths of an inch smaller than a full 1 inch in diameter. So a quarter is just slightly less in diameter than 1 inch. 1/10000th of an inch is 1/10 in machinist speak, and that should not be confused with 1/10 of an inch.